بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. في الكورس of the clinical dental pharmacology هنبتدي نتكلم النهاردة عن الـ antihistamines which used for treatment of allergic conditions. You must study well the antihistamines to be familiar with these drugs for two reasons. Number one, in allergic patients before the dental procedures it's better to use the antihistamines to decrease the symptoms of the high fever, make the breathing of the patients more easier. Antihistamines used usually for allergic conditions to a drug. Severe allergic reactions usually yield epinephrine. Antihistamines, mild allergic reaction. Antihistamine has a side effects. Side effects بتاعت antihistamines نتيجة anticholinergic effects of it بتبقى xerostomia dry mouth. Dry mouth ممكن يؤدي إلى increase في dental caries, increase في mouth infections and gum disorders. Before study antihistaminic, أنا لازم أعرف الهستامينيك receptors. أنا عندي في H1 وفي H2 في other histaminic receptors. H1 موجود مني في السموث ماسل والاندوثيليوم في البلاد فيسلز, موجود في البرين وده المسؤول عن الفازو دايلاتيشن والانكريز فاسكولار بيرميابيليتي. الهستامين تايب 2 ريسبتورز موجود في الجاستريك ميوكوزا واللي بتزود الاتش سي ال سيكريشنز, برضو موجوده في البرين, موجوده في الكاردياك ماسل. بس انا مهم جدا بالنسبه لي اعرف ان الاتش 1 بتاعه البلاد فيسلز بتاعه الفازو دايلاتيشنز اعراض الارتكاريا, اوكي, والاتش 2 ريسبتورز بتاع الاتش سي ال سيكريشن الموجود في الاستومك. في others مش مهمين بالنسبة لنا as a dental students. الباثولوجيكال رول اوف ذا هيستامين, الهيستامين مسؤول عن الالرجي بالديجريز بتاعته. لوكال رياكشنز زي ممكن بريورايتس, ارتكاريا, ممكن انافيلكتيك شوك. انافيلكتيك شوك هيستامين سيفيرلي ريليزد all over the body, فبالتالي بيديني severe vasodilatation, hypotension and shock. يبقى الانافيلكتيك شوك هو severe secretion of the histamine والsubsequent effect بالvasodilatation والhypotension. البرونكيال ازمة الميديتورز الهستامين as a mediators has a minor role, مش هو الرول الأساسي. بعد كده عندي الهستامين لي رول في الفوميتينج of vestibular origin. أنا عندي الفوميتينج من كذا مصدر. الفوميتينج لو بصيت على شكله ده الفوميتينج سنتر, بيجي له impulse من different sites of our body, من الجي اي تي, من السي ان اس, من السي تي زد سنترز, ومن الفيستيبولر apparatus. الفيستيبولر apparatus الريسبتورز أو transmitters بتعمل له stimulation الهستامين والأستايل كولين. يبقى لوجيكالي لو انا استخدمت انتي هيستامينيك بتبلوك ريسبتور ده او استخدمت انتي ماسكورينيك اللي بتبلوك ريسبتور ده هيبقى ليه انتي ايماتيك ايفكت. يبقى الهيستامين از رول او از باثولوجيكال رول ليه رول في الاندكشن اوف فوميتنج ثرو ذا فيستيبولر سيستم. الناس اللي عندهم مشكله في الفيستيبولر سيستم ده اللي هو اللي عندهم موشن سيكنس, اللي عندهم انر اير ديس اوردرز, اوكي, والبيبتيك السر. يبقى الهيستامين بالاتش 2 بيبتيك السر. ليه الاتش 2 بيبقى مسؤول عن ال HCL secretions and so disorders فيها ممكن يديني البيبتيك ulcer. وال H1 بيبقى مسؤول عن الالرجي وال vomiting of the vestibular origin. الانتيهستامينز أنا عندي في H1 antihistamine وفي H2 blockers. Usually the expression of antihistamine denoting ال H1 antihistamine. ال H2 blockers it said H2 blockers مش antihistamines. Okay, في other drugs which has an antihistaminic or antagonizing histamine effect. ال H1 usually allergic condition. ال H2 okay peptic ulcer. ال other disorder, ال other other drugs, ال epinephrine, physiological antagonist of histamine. يعني ايه physiological antagonist of histamine؟ ال epinephrine okay induce vasoconstriction and bronchodilation which antagonize the effect of histamine which is vasoconstriction. Okay, sorry, vasodilatation and bronchoconstriction. Okay, the physiological effect act on a different receptors but antagonizing the effect of histamine. And so, epinephrine used as a life-saving measure in anaphylactic shock because it is الفيسيولوجيكال انتاجونست اوف هيستامين. البيتا 2 اجونست والماست سيل ستابلايزر بوث اوف ذم هاز ان ماست ستيل ستابلايزنج افكت وديكريز الماست سيل ديجرانيوليشن وريليز اوف هيستامين. اوكي, التوبكس اوف انتي هيستامينك توداي از discussing الانتيهستامين H1 antihistamine. The first generations or second generation the available drugs. First or second generation. The first generation such as the promethazine and chlorpheniramine. The newer generation such as fexofenadine and loratadine. Usually the newer generation is better than its first generations and there is some points of differences. Okay, lot of slides will be discussed. The first generation mechanism of actions. The mechanism of action of the first generation number one antihistaminic by inverse agonist effect on the H1 receptors. What's meant by inverse agonist? There is difference between the inverse agonist, pure agonist and the antagonist. The pure agonist increase or convert the inactive state of the receptors to the active state. The antagonist, there is no change from the effect of the antagonist attached to the receptor and has no effect, has affinity or no efficacy. The inverse agonist convert a constitutionally active receptor into inactive receptor. The H1 antihistamines act by inverse agonist effect on the histamine type 1 receptor, plus muscarinic blockers, plus alpha blocking effect, and serotonin blockers. So it's H1 inverse agonist plus blocking autonomic nervous system and the serotonin receptors. The first generations, which is different from the second generation mechanism of action. The first generation's pharmacological effect and uses anti-allergic blocking H1 mediated allergy. Okay. In allergic conditions such as rhinitis, urticaria, anaphylactic shock, okay, the antihistamine ineffective in treatment of bronchial asthma because the other mediators has a major role than the histamine. يبقى number one في pharmacological effect of antihistamine anti-allergic, so used in different allergic conditions except bronchial asthma has no role. It has lipophilic antihistamines crossing the blood-brain barrier, so leads to CNS depression. A depressant effect can be used as an OTC hypnotics, can be used as an antitussif. Antitussif suppression lil cough center can be used in dry cough. A muscarinic blocker's effect, because it's a muscarinic blocker and antihistaminic, it has an anti-emetic effect, so can be used in vomiting, especially vomiting of the motion sickness. Motion sickness اللي هو ليه علاقة بالstimulation of the vestibular system. A first generation side effects, CNS هو بيكروس اللايبوفيليك, mostly of them بيكروس اللايبوفيليك وcrossing blood-brain barrier leading to drowsiness, okay, drowsiness, sedation, which is a side effects, for many reasons, okay, but agitation in children, paradoxical effect in the pharmacology, some drugs has a paradox effect, controversial effect, okay, agitation in children. It has an atropine-like effect because it has an anti-muscarinic action. The atropine side effects. The atropine side effects, the dry mouth, مهم جدا بالنسبة لي عشان the dental hygiene. يبقى the dry mouth, okay, the dry mouth هيزود the infection وهيزود the dental caries. Okay, leads to confusions, leads to urine retention, constipation, sinus tachycardia. الإفكت of the atropine, وده هتشرح لكم في lectures كاملة, بنتكلم عن الأتروبين. الأتروبين بيعمل إيه؟ بيعمل إيه sinus tachycardia. الالفا بلوكينج افكت leads to postural hypotension. اوكي, الفا بلوكينج افكت common side effects of the alpha blocker drugs is postural hypotension. والhypotension leads to reflex tachycardia. ده first generation's side effects. A new generation antihistaminic بتختلف عن او different او compared by the first generation by less lipophilic, so less crossing blood brain barrier and less sedations. Okay, of advantage. Of advantage, very important, but the uses of the first generation related to crossing the blood-brain barrier can be used in the second generations. Less lipophilic, less sedations. Delayed eliminations, the single daily dose. Less autonomic side effects, no anti-muscarinic, no alpha-blocking effect, no serotonin. No to lesser degree means lesser effect, not total no. Okay? So the uses of the second generation only in the allergic conditions. Quiz. A patient is going on a deep sea fishing trip and is worried about motion sickness. Which of the following is the most appropriate? First generation or second generation's motion sickness or the anti-emetic effect related to the anti-muscarinic effect of the antihistamine. So we must use first generation. Okay, number one, first generation. Number two, it's prior to or after the onset, usually the antihistamine has a prophylactic effect. So it must be given prior to the departure. So the answer will be first generation antihistaminic 1 hour prior to the departures. Your neighbors said she used an antihistamine that was available over the counter and it caused her marked drowsiness, dry mouth, and she slept quite longer than usual. Which is the most possible drug that she used? Antihistamine with a sedating effect, dryness, dry secretions for mouth. Dry mouth means anticholinergic effect. Okay, so This is a first generation antihistamine. The answer will be chlorpheniramine. Which one of the following pairs of the drug indication is accurate? Loratidine antitussive? No, loratidine, first, second generation. Fexofenadine, second generation, can be used in allergic rhinitis, but this is true. This loratidine, motion sickness, no, the second generation not used. Chlorpheniramine, first generation, but antihistamine is totally not used in bronchial asthma. Promethazine for productive cough, no, productive cough, not used antitussive. We usually use mucolytics and expectorant. So the answer will be fexofenadine in allergic rhinitis. A summary of the following lectures. Antihistamines, okay, act as an inverse agonist on the H1 receptor and block different types of receptor. The anticholinergic effect of the receptor will lead to dry mouth, urine retention, constipation, tachycardia. The alpha blocking effect will lead to postural hypotension and reflex tachycardia. A serotonin effect blocking, increasing the appetite. Not all of the drugs have the same effect. Some drugs have more effect on serotonin. Some of them have more anticholinergic effect. Okay, but it's different. Okay, and طبعاً antihistaminic effect leads to decrease في allergic reaction, sedations, decrease في cognitive functions, increase في appetite. And so this is the total effect of antihistamine. Thank you.